I'm here with new topic, veins. There are four types of veins: planetary veins, periodical veins, local veins, and sudden or irregular veins. In today's class, we'll learn about planetary veins and its type. So there are three types of planetary veins: trade veins, westerlies, and polar veins. So first of all, let us see, what do you mean by veins? What are veins? So veins refer to the horizontal movement of an air from one place to another. So air moves from one place to another in a horizontal manner, and that movement of an air is referred to as wind. So veins are mostly generated because of difference in heating of land surface. When there is difference in the heating of land surface, there is difference in its temperature. Difference in temperature means difference in pressure. So because of the difference in pressure, there is the movement of air from high pressure area to low pressure area. The wind does not blow with the same speed all over the world. There is the difference in the speed with which the wind blows. So speed of a wind depends on the difference in the pressure between high pressure area and low pressure area. The greater is the difference, the higher is the speed, and the smaller is the difference, lower is the speed of the wind. So wind does not blow in a regular path, or it does not always blow in a straight line. They change their direction with its movement. While it blows from one place to another, it often changes its direction. So this change in direction is because of the rotational force of the earth. Because of the rotation of the earth, the wind changes its path as well as its direction. As the earth rotates, it gives rise to the Coriolis force. And this Coriolis force in turn affects the movement of the wind. So for an example, this is your earth. We all know that it spins in its axis. So when it is rotating, rotation of the earth is indicated with the help of arrow. So it is rotating from west to east. So when it rotates, it gives rise to a force which is known as Coriolis force. And because of this Coriolis force, the wind which goes towards the northern hemisphere deflects towards its right. And the wind which is moving towards the southern hemisphere deflects towards its left. And this rule of the deflection of wind from its regular path towards the right side in the northern hemisphere and towards the left side in the southern hemisphere is known as Farrell's law. So the force because of which the wind deflects from its regular path and moves towards right side in the northern hemisphere and move towards left side in the southern hemisphere, that force is known as Coriolis force. And that law or rule of the deflection of this wind is known as Farrell's law. Now we move on to the very first type of wind, that is planetary winds. Planetary winds are also known as prevailing winds or permanent winds. Planetary winds, prevailing winds, and permanent winds are all same type of wind. So planetary winds are the winds which blows from one direction to another throughout the year. It does not change its direction. So there are three subtypes of planetary winds. Those are trade winds, westerlies, and polar winds. So trade winds, they are the type of planetary winds. Lastly, we have polar winds. So polar winds blow from polar regions to temperate regions. So they blow from polar high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt in both the hemisphere. So in the northern hemisphere, these polar winds, they blow from northeast direction and hence are known as northeast polar winds. And in the southern hemisphere, they blow from southeast direction and hence are known as southeast polar winds. So these winds are very cold and they mostly blow from the polar regions. So the basic characteristics of polar winds are they blow from polar high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt. They are very cold and they become warm when they cross the oceans. Trade winds are the permanent winds which blows from 5 degree to 30 degree in both the hemisphere, in northern as well as southern hemisphere. Trade winds are named so because these winds were very helpful to the sailors to sail ships. During ancient times, when oceans and seas were one of the chief means of transportation, these oceans and seas were used to transport a bulky loads from one place to another. And during those days, these trade winds proved to be very helpful for the sailors to sail ships from one place to another. That is why they are known as trade winds. And the phrase to blow trade means to blow steadily and constantly in one direction. So these trade winds blow from subtropical high pressure belt to equatorial low pressure belt in both the hemisphere. So subtropical high pressure belt is the area of high pressure and equatorial low pressure belt is the area of low pressure. So trade winds blow from the area of high pressure to the area of low pressure. And it always blows between 5 degree latitude to 30 degree latitude north and south. It is the main characteristics of the trade wind. So in the northern hemisphere, because of the Coriolis force, the wind gets deflected, we know that. So the wind blows from northeastern side. And in the southern hemisphere, the wind blows from southeastern side. Okay. So these winds in the northern hemisphere is known as northeast trade winds. And in southern hemisphere, it is known as southeast trade winds. They are known as northeast and southeast trade winds because of their direction of the flow. So these trade winds brings rainfall in the eastern side of the continent and it does not bring any rainfall in the western side of the continent. So towards the east, it brings most of the rainfall and towards the west, it does not bring any rainfall. So that is why we find most of the desert in the western part of the world, specially confined to this belt between subtropical high pressure belt and the equatorial low pressure belt. Some of the examples of the desert are Atacama Desert, Kalahari Desert and Sahara Desert, which we find towards the western margin of the continent. Next we have is westerlies. Westerlies are the prevailing winds which blows from 30 degree to 60 degree latitude in both the hemisphere. Westerlies blows from subtropical high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt. So in the northern hemisphere, westerlies are known as southwest westerlies because they blow from southwestern direction. Here. And in the southern hemisphere, they are known as northwest westerlies because they are blowing from northwest direction. Yeah, this is your northwest westerlies. They are getting deflected because of the Coriolis force. So in the northern hemisphere, these westerlies, they do not blow with the consistency. They are not constant and they are not regular because of the presence of land mass, because of the friction. They are not regular in the northern hemisphere. Whereas in the southern hemisphere, these westerlies blow with great regularity because of the presence of oceans. So they are known by different name in the various latitude by which they pass. So they are known as roaring 40s in 40 degree latitude. They are known as furious 50s in 50 degree, and they are known as shrieking or screaming 60s in 60 degrees. So they are very violent winds, and they pose great danger for shipping. They are often characterized by gales, stormy weather, overcast sky, and seamen also call them the brave west winds because they are very, very strong as compared to other winds. Cyclones and anticyclones also commonly originate where the westerlies blow. So in winters, westerly winds blow onshore and brings rainfall in the western part of continent. Some of the basic characteristics of westerlies are they blow from subtropical high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt. They blow within 30 degree and 60 degree latitudes in both the hemisphere. They are very strong. They are violent, characterized by strong winds, overcast sky, and stormy weather. They are known as furious 50s, roaring 40s, and shrieking or screaming 60s, according to the latitude on which they blow. And they also bring rainfall in the western part of continents during winter season. Lastly, we have polar winds. So polar winds blow from polar regions to temperate regions. So they blow from polar high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt in both the hemisphere. So in the northern hemisphere, these polar winds, they blow from northeast direction, and hence are known as northeast polar winds. And in the southern hemisphere, they blow from southeast direction, and hence are known as southeast polar winds. So these winds are very cold, and they mostly blow from the polar regions. So the basic characteristics of polar winds are they blow from polar high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt. They are very cold, and they become warm when they cross the oceans.